Into this video, I'm going to compare these two banks in Zambia, which is First National Bank and Standard Chartered Bank. So by the end of this video, you're going to find out which one among these two banks is the best in Zambia. So we are actually going to write this post together. So I've already written a table. So we've got the feature table, we've got the FNB and the Standard Chartered, and we're going to fill in all the information, and by the end of this table here, we're going to see which one among this bank is the best. So choosing a bank account in Zambia is actually a big challenge, okay, because like most of the information that you will need is not publicly available like on their website, okay. So this information is information that you have to get from people or by contacting the bank, but that's so time consuming. So by the end of this video, you won't have to pass through all that just to find the information you need. Everything will be talked about in this video. So I'm going to talk about both the advantages and the disadvantages. But in our case, the reason why you want a bank account is for us to be able to make both local and international payments. Like on this channel, all we do or what we talk about is making money online. So we want to be able to pay, and we also want to be able to receive money both in Zambia and both from international companies. Like it should work like from forex brokers or from freelance marketplaces. Okay, everything should work. Apart from that, you're also looking for a bank that provides low fees, good support, and also most importantly, being able to do everything from the comfort of your home using your phone without having to visit the bank. So which bank among these two is the best for this? So let the battle begin. So it's FNB versus Standard Chartered. So let's begin. So we've got a feature, the FNB, and finally StanChart. So the first thing we're going to talk about is account opening. Like, how is it easy to open an account? Okay, so when it comes to opening an account, yes, it's easy to open an account with any of these banks. But for FNB, like if we're to open an FNB account, unless things have changed, as far as I know, like you need someone, more like a relative, who has got an FNB account, okay, to act as if as your referral or something like that. Like you cannot open one on your own unless things have changed, okay. So, and to open this bank account, you obviously have to visit a branch near you to open one. But for Standard Chartered does not like you don't need to have someone with an account with Standard Chartered. Like actually you also don't need to visit the bank to create an account, to open an account. So for Standard Chartered, like all you need to do is simply download the app on your phone, create an account there, okay, and there and then the account will be opened and they actually deliver your card to your place within 2 weeks. So when it comes to account opening, we are now in the future. We are now in 2023, almost entering 2024. Okay, days are over, but you have to visit the bank to do everything. As of now, like you don't need to visit the bank to do things. So Standard Chartered here is the best because all you need to do is simply install the app on your phone and open up your bank account just there. So here first, Standard Chartered wins. Okay. And here FNB is still living in the past, but let me show you the proof so that you can see what I'm talking about. So if you search up AC Zambia, shortcut for Standard Chartered Zambia, okay, and click on Standard Chartered, okay, if you want you can also open an account on this same website, but usually you'll be redirected to use the app. So click on open account, then you're going to be told open your bank account instantly on our AC mobile app. Then simply click here, then to redirect you whether you choose for iPhone or for Android, then you download the app and to be able to do everything on your phone. Then for FNB, so for FNB you cannot open online. So when you click, for example, for me, it's simply going to find types of accounts and everything you need to know about the accounts. Then you can call them or apply now, but still it won't work. So simply have to visit the branch unless things have changed. So let's go to the next thing. So now that we have opened an account, the next thing I think which is important is fees. Okay. So there are banks, okay, that charge a lot of fees. Some fees are necessary. Okay. So which bank has got low fees? Okay, so when it comes to FNB, FNB yes has got low fees. Okay, for personal accounts, but when it comes to Standard Chartered has no monthly management fees. So when you download the app and create a smart banking account, like, it's free, like there's no monthly fees that you need to pay. But of course there are fees per transaction that you pay. For example, if you're sending money from your bank account to Airtel Money or MTN, there's a certain fee you pay. If you're paying online using your card, there's a certain fee. Okay, also these fees are there on FNB. Okay, they are there, but FNB has got monthly fees that you pay unless on some other accounts, but for Standard Chartered is completely no fees. And what I've noticed is that the fees on Standard Chartered are lower as compared to FNB, so FNB still loses over here. So now that we've talked about the fees, what next should we talk about? Let's talk about support. Okay, so there are some times whereby you may be trying to pay for some things online, then suddenly your card declines, okay, even if you have money, or sometimes there's simply problems that come that require the support or assistance of the bank. So the question is, how is it easy to get support or to get help? So when it comes to FNB, like, if you need help, you need to contact their number, okay? But even though when you contact their number, most of the problems, they will require you visiting the branch in order for you to solve them, okay? And the other bad thing is that the number on FNB, you can only call during working days and during working hours, okay? So working days, during working hours. So here, FNB has lost, but when it comes to Standard Chartered, you can call Standard Chartered at any time of the day, okay? So you can call Standard Chartered at 01, they'll pick up, 02, they'll pick up, Sunday, Saturday, they'll pick up. But for FNB, you have to call them during working hours and during working days. And again, when you call Standard Chartered at any time of the day, okay, they will still be able to fix what, like, the problem you're going through. Like, you won't have to go to the branch. So most of my problems have been fixed on a call, but for FNB, they have not been fixed on a call. I've always been referred to go to a nearest branch in order for them to be fixed. So Standard Chartered wins here. So now that we've talked about support, let's also talk about security. So what type of security are we talking about? So how secure it is, because these days, like, all you do is you bank on your phone, simply install the app, you'll be able to do everything on your phone, okay? But remember that when it comes to security, this is something that you also have to put in effort in securing. For example, not sharing your PIN, okay? Not opening your bank accounts, like in buses where anyone can see you typing the PIN or password. Okay, always making sure that you don't install unknown apps on your phone. Like, these are things which you have to do on your own to make sure that you don't get scammed or something like that, or lose access. Okay, but one thing I've noticed about security is that when you go for support, like when you call FNB, To verify that you are the owner of the account, all they will ask you for is your NRC number. Then the NRC number, yeah, it of course is linked to your account, so they'll be able to pull all the details they want from your account by only providing your NRC number. So when it comes to a Standard Chartered, they won't ask for your NRC number. Rather, all they will ask you for is your account number. But they won't end there. When they ask for your account number, they're going to ask you for your the last two or three transactions that you remember happening on the account. They're going to ask you your date of birth. They're going to ask you your phone number. They're going to ask you a lot of questions to prove that you are the owner of that account. So I think in terms of security, Standard Chartered wins, because anyone who knows your NRC can call support and ask whatever they want to ask. And that's just bad. For me, that does not make sense. Like, why should they only ask for an NRC? Like, they need to ask a lot of things to prove that you are the owner of that account, and they should proceed and help you. So if someone knows your NRC, in short, they can call FNB and find out how much money you have. But I don't know if they can tell you the balance. Okay, they'll just tell you, like, you can simply log into the app and do whatever. But you never know, okay? People these days are bad. If someone knows your NRC, they can do a lot of things. So security here, again, I just hope, like, FNB is watching this video so that they can work on this. This is just bad. So security has lost. So what next? What should we talk about? Okay, let's talk about usability. Usability. Like, how easy is it to use these banks? So when it comes to the FNB app, yeah, you're able to buy airtime, send money, do a lot of things using the app. Okay, on Standard Chartered, you're also able to do everything on the app. Like, most of the things, you don't have to visit the bank. You can make transfers, withdrawals. Okay, on both accounts, you can make cashless withdrawals. You can do a lot of things. So here, when it comes to usability, they both win. Okay, what next should we talk about? Let me think. Okay, I think this is it. Okay, I thought I was going to have a long list of features to compare with, whereby I would end reach here. But I think these are the most important features that I've outlined. So, okay, if you use any of these banks, feel free to share your experience. Okay, if I'm wrong somewhere, feel free to comment. Okay, if there's something you'd like to add, feel free to comment, and I'll be able to add them to this list here. So I'm going to be updating this post, okay, because things change. So as maybe in case there's any improvements, I'll be able to change this and be able to make sure that I write that on this post. So we've finally written this post, and what we're going to do is we're going to publish this post. But before I publish it, obviously people are going to be reading this post. They won't be able to understand, because what does lost and win mean here? So this is why I need to first publish the video. When I publish the video, I need to, okay, add the video in this post so that people can watch the video and also read this post, and they'll be able to understand better and know which bank is the best. So to conclude, the question is, which bank is the best? So for now, okay, for now, Standard Chartered is the best and FNB is the worst. Okay, so according, this is based on what we've talked about. So Standard Chartered is the best and FNB. But one thing I forgot to talk about, for example, if you're a forex trader, okay, so if you're a forex trader, depending on the broker you are using, so when it comes to FNB, like, if you deposit money into your, let's say for example, the Reef trading account, and you'd like to withdraw, like, if you're using FNB, sometimes you'll be told that you can only withdraw any amount less or equal to the amount you deposited. But in my case, with Standard Chartered, like, if I deposit, let us say, $50 into my trading account, and I make, let us say, double that amount, I'll still be able to withdraw no matter how big the amount is. Like, I'm not restricted to only withdrawing an amount less than or equal to the amount I deposited. So, again, our Standard Chartered here again wins. Okay, so consider yourself like watching this video, because this is some information that I wish I knew before I got into these things. Because, yeah, like this, as I said earlier on, this is information that is not publicly available. Yeah, so as I said earlier on, this channel is all about making money in Zambia. And if you are really interested in making serious money online in Zambia, I actually have got courses that can actually help you with that. So I've got the affiliate course, which is going at 175 kwacha. It teaches you how you can actually make money with affiliate marketing. Then I've got the best course, of which I highly recommend anyone getting into. It is the crypto course, which is this one. It teaches you everything you need to know about cryptocurrencies and how you can actually make money with them. And most importantly, the forex trading course. This is a course that I spent more than 6 months creating. This is everything you need to know and being able to make money trading the forex market. And finally, this one is 2000 kwacha. The crypto is 500, then affiliate 175. This course teaches you how to buy things online, and selling in Zambia is only 100 kwacha. So if you'd like to enroll in this course, in any of my courses, simply WhatsApp me, send me a message on WhatsApp. My number is easy, it is 0977, okay, 0977 77, then 0202. So 0977 77 0202, that's my WhatsApp number. So bye for now. This is Keith. Remember to share your experience in the comment section. Bye for now.